So in order to get ahead of them and to be the best, you need to do those extra things.
Legacy, this is forever. All the more times I've been seven, I'm raising the bar, you can go ahead and measure. You know, yeah, this right here for rev.
So Jacob, tell us how it started for you, man.
Well, I was playing in the NPL here at the time, and you identified me and sent me over to Cyprus after working about a year together.
How old were you?
I was 18 at the time, and I went and trialled with Upper Well, ex-Champions League club at the time, and I signed with their youth team.
Under 20s, yeah?
Yeah.
The remarkable thing though, Jacob, is you went from being an amateur, training 2-3 times a week, to then into the under 20 squad and then into the seniors. Like you were starting to train with the seniors and then starting to sit on the senior bench. How did you feel about that?
Yeah, well, it was a big step up from playing NPL here, training 2-3 times a week, to going there and training every single day pretty much. Our pre-seasons were even training 2 times a day. So it was a big shock to the body, and it took me a while to adapt, but once I adapted, I found myself in the senior team, and being a part of that was really good.
How did it feel? I mean, you're part of the squad to go play in the Europa League against Athletic Bilbao, was it?
Yeah.
And then how did it feel? Like after that, you got osteitis pubis, you had problems in the groins, you know, then all of a sudden you're there knocking on the door to be in the seniors and you're out for 6 months.
It was pretty hard to take at the time. As you said, I was knocking on the door. I was really close to getting in the squad. I'd sat on the bench multiple times, and it got to a stage where, yeah, my groins were just aggravating me a lot. And then I got scans done and it was osteitis pubis. So I was out for about 5 to 6 months. The doctors didn't really know what to do with me, and it all came crashing down, if you like to say it like that. And it was very hard for me at the time, mentally trying to focus on getting myself right, being away from home. Mum and dad helped me a lot. And it was a tough time, but I got through it.
So you got a bit homesick, but you didn't pack it up. You had great family support and you stuck it out, got yourself together again.
Yeah, Mum and Dad were a big help, speaking to me every day and just reminding me that I'm there for a purpose. So there was times where, yeah, I just didn't want to come back home, but it was good to stick it out and build character during that time, and it made the person I am today.
And ultimately, you won the season that year.
Yeah, I ended up coming back towards the end of the season. I did sit on the bench at the end, and it was the last game we had won the league. And yeah, we ended up becoming champions, and that was a good achievement as well.
It was a massive achievement, coming from an unknown club in Australia, in a small league. No disrespect to the league, the NPL is a decent league, but going and playing one of the, you know, at least top 20 clubs of Europe, you know?
Yeah, it was a massive step, and it was like I had to really understand this position I was in, because, you know, a year before I was playing local league football here at a park, and then I'm playing in front of 20,000-30,000 in Cyprus. So it was a big jump, but it was an amazing experience for me.
What would you say to other youngsters that are aspiring to become footballers? Like, what are they got to do to get there? What are they got to do to stay there?
Yeah, it's very mental, and building your character is very important. I'd say just in order to stay ahead of the rest, you need to continue to be consistent, train, and understand that it's all going to come to something. You can't expect to not work for something that you want to achieve. So just continue to work hard and you'll get there.
What about setbacks? What about if they get dropped, or, you know, like a coach comes to the club, a new coach, or
what should they do
if they fall out of favour with the coach? How important is it to be mentally tough?
The first thing is to believe in yourself. Understand that you are the best player, and you have to continue to tell yourself that, because there'll be coaches that won't believe in you. There'll be players that will want to put you down, that will want to play ahead of you. So you have to continue to believe in yourself and understand that you're the only person that can get you to where you want to be. So be mentally strong about it and you'll get there.
And Jacob, I mean, you've played over 150 professional games now. You're 23 years old. How do you feel now that you're living your dreams? I know you haven't got to where you want to be, but you are going to get there. I believe in you. How does it feel like being a professional with, you know, over 150 games?
Definitely the last 3 years have become a big help to me, allowed me to become the player I am today and mature. You know, I've realized at the end of every season that I've just become better and better, and it's good to have these professional games now and to be getting and working towards the player I want to be and the team I want to be in.
I know you, Jacob, since you're 18, and I know how hard you work and what your work ethics are like. I know you train every day with the club and you're in the gym as well. How important is it? Do you see other pros doing that as well, like at your clubs?
Yeah, it's definitely something you need to do in order to get ahead of the rest. So even in Upper Well, there was a lot of players that would just wait for the training every day. So in order to get ahead of them and to be the best, you need to do those extra things. You know, you need to be in the gym, you need to watch your diet, watch your sleep. These are the small little 1%ers that get you ahead of your opponent. And it's very important that you can do that.
All right, Jack. Well, look, all the best for the new season coming up,
man. Thank you.
And keep kicking ass.
Thanks.